Welcome to Kusum.net. This is ASP.net MVC tutorial and you are watching part 39 list box in ASP.net MVC. In this session, you will learn implementing list box in ASP.net MVC. Before watching this video, please watch my previous parts, part 36, part 37 and part 38. In part 38, I was explained about checkbox list in ASP.net MVC. So let's start the programming and flip to the Visual Studio. Before flip to the Visual Studio, we will see what type of output we need. We need this type of output. This is my list box and inside of that there is city names. When I click on this submit button, it will display the city names, whatever you have selected by pressing control. Okay, you can select multiple cities and it will display the message you have selected city 1, city 2, whatever. Okay, and if you didn't select any city, it will display you didn't selected any city. Okay, let's flip to the Visual Studio. Okay, let's begin to create a class. Before creating a class, we have to see that which table we have to use. Okay, this is my table TBL city. Okay, and this TBL city have three fields: ID, city name, and is selected property. Okay, so let's start to create a class which defines the selected items and the values of the list box. So this is ID, name and is selected properties. ID have auto increment, name have string data type and is selected have bit data type, right? So right click on models and create city view model. I think this is create, but remove this. Right now, create one class. Add class. Suppose my class name is view model. Okay, this is view model dot cs. Inside of this view model class, I will create public IEnumerable select list item, but this select list item will be available after giving the namespace using this property is for selected list items. So this get set, not selected but all the list box items. Okay, now copy this and create one another select for selected list item, selected list items box. Okay, so string this and give it name selected cities, right? Selected cities, remove this. Okay, this my class is created now. So now I will go to the controller. The name of controller is my default controller. So go inside of this and create for that where this view model is situated. It is situated inside of this web application 1.models. So we will add this web application 1.models namespace inside of this controller. So using and paste. Okay, now we need the entity data model. Before that, I have a You can see here, this is my data entity model for this city class. My city class name was TBL city, but I have renamed it here and given the name city. Okay, let's go to the controller. And now this data entity model have this entity one data context class. So I have added this and created this DB object for it. Now I will use this DB object inside of this index controller HTTP gate. Okay. Now what I have to first create, I have to create a list of select list item. So list select list item, because inside of list box I want select list item. Okay, and give it the name S list. Okay, select list item S list equal to new list of select list item, remove it. Okay, now I want each select list item from the city table. So for each city from city table, create object city in, from where, from these view models, these cities. Okay, all list box items. So I will add from in cities, cities. Why though is not created? And we'll add the name text value. So text text not added. Why? Because, right guys, this city will come, cities will come from this list item. Okay, and remove this here. Now I will add here that I will add here the text text equal to what the object name, this city. So city dot name, and I want value. So value equal to city dot id, value from id, city dot id dot to string. Okay, and then what I need, I need selected value. So selected equal to city object dot is selected. Okay, and now what I will do, I will add this select list item to this S list. Okay, for that what I will do, I will call this S list here. So S list dot add, what I will add, I will add this select list item, select item. So this will go here. Okay, and now I will create, now I will create view model object. So my view model suppose VM equal to new view model. Okay, and now this view model will accept the properties of the city. So VM dot these cities. Okay, so VM dot cities equal to VM dot these cities equal to this S list. So S list. And processing is the processing here. Now I will return view, and inside of that I will add this VM, okay, VM object. So this finished here. Okay, and now create the view page for that add view. Okay, add view and index page without any model. Create. I have already created that view, so let's see that view. Okay, go to the view. You can see here I have created this model inside of my view page, and model web application 1.models cities view model, but now my view model is view model. Okay, so I will change this name to view model. Okay, and I have created inside of this using html.begin form this list box @html.listbox4, and inside of that I have called this selected cities, which inside of this class I have this selected cities. Okay, so copy this and paste here, and call one cities property, so model.cities. Why? Because all the items are listed in this cities, so I have got this. Okay, and after br tag breaking I have put on this button. Okay, submit button. Now save it, build this view class. Right, my class is now builded. So let's start and run the program, and what gonna happen we see now. Okay, so you can see here this is my list box, and it has some items whichever in the table. Okay, when I click on this city and submit, there is no message. Okay, so we have to give the error messages that you have selected this one or this one. For that, what I will do, I will add post method inside of this controller. Okay, so control C and write the post method here. I remove all these things from here. Okay, and add here the HTTP post, right? Now I will use here the if condition. Okay, for that, before that I want to add here, pass the parameter, this parameter from the view model, this IEnumerable. Okay, so IEnumerable string, IEnumerable string, and give the names selected cities, this same name. Okay, because we want to use this selected list item and to display the message for that, so we have to use that same one. Okay, here, and now I will use if condition. If this selected cities so if selected cities equal to null, okay, then give the string message. For that you will use your string and return the message, return you didn't selected any city, right? Else you have to pass the string. For that I have add here using system.txt namespace, right? Now display the messages. For that you will use string builder class. So string builder, suppose SB object equal to new string builder, okay, and use this SB object to append the list. So SB.append, before displaying the message you will add you have selected comma separator, okay? So plus string dot join. What you want to join? You want to join separator of comma. So comma and with what? With selected list item, selected cities. So selected cities, right? And return this join string with this list of cities. So return sb dot string, okay. My program is finished here, and let's check what gonna happen using this index. Okay, I have got this error message. I will remove this return view from here and save it. And okay, and click on submit button. You can see here you have selected one, means anyone is selected, right? Selected 145. Okay, when you scroll this, you can see here the city, but when I fix the size, set the size this list box, then it will don't show this scroll bar button. For that, what I will do, I will do here, I will set the size using this overloaded version, new, this object HTML attributes, so new size equal to suppose 6. Now save it and run it. So refresh this page, F5. You have selected two, and pressing control you can select multiple cities. So you have selected 1 to 4, right? So guys, this is end of session of this program. Thank you for watching my video, and if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. If you have already subscribed, then please like it, share it. Thank you. Have a good day.